Making someone else's life better, then you're wasting your time. Your life will become better by making other lives better. And that's AJ. Anthony Stop Button Gilberry. The head busting, hard knocking, redhead man. Brother of mine, and I wouldn't trade him for the world. Man, this guy has been such a joy to my life, and not only my life, but many others. His hard work, dedication, his sense of humor is just truly one of a kind, and you don't bump into individuals like him every day. This is my guy, my dog, AJ. Y'all keep tapping in. Y'all gonna enjoy this one. This is Perseverance.
Hello, everybody. Nice to meet y'all. I'm Anthony McGearberry, but go by AJ. I'm from Lower Mississippi. And things you might know about me, stuff that I like is I like big trucks, horses, football, you know, I like to play around, paintball, stuff like that. And what I'm gonna talk about today is things I had to overcome, as in things I had to deal with growing up. And the main thing I did growing up was finding myself. It took a while. It took a couple years actually. I was very shy back then. I was afraid and more concerned about what other people would say on my actions or reactions. So I just stayed down low, you know, live according to other people's standards. And that was pretty much, it was bad. You don't want to live like that because you won't see the full potential of what you can do. And now that I'm where I'm at now, I'm able to just live how I want to. And I got more energy on the inside as to want to express myself on how I feel. And it feels good to express how I really feel and not have to hide behind other people, you know, standards. But growing up, it was kind of rough. I mean, I come from the projects of Queensburg, actually Brown Circle. It was rough, man. It was cool at the same time, but it was pretty much rough as in living lifestyle. We didn't have much. Government apartment. It was crazy, man. As far as dealing with trying to, what you gonna eat the next day, who gonna bully you the next day, where money gonna come from. Or stuff like that, man. I wasn't too much street involved, but I was out there as far as like hanging out, playing around, stuff like that. So I wasn't really just a, you know, street guy, something like that. But came across a lot of people, a lot, a whole bunch of different personalities and stuff like that. And what just kept everything together for us, everybody played sports. My mom, she was pretty much a leader in the community. She put sports teams together. The main one she did was basketball. And that's how I was able to really just connect with a lot of people, because I was shy. It took for somebody to come speak to me before I speak to them. And that's how I gained friends throughout where I was growing up at. And a lot of people I'm thankful to know from back there. Because pretty much everybody had the same lifestyle, man. They didn't have much or had no other choice but to be there. And man, there's so much you could say, man. Because I grew up in a house of six kids, single mom, single parent, six of us, two boys, and two sets of twin girls. And surviving, it was an everyday thing. Seeing beer collectors come to the house, calling the phone, dealing with internal family issues. It was crazy, man. But I'm thankful for everything that we went through. My mom, she's a keeper, man. Don't know too many people that would be able to withhold or withstand stuff like that on their own. My dad, he wasn't around much back during those days. So dealing with that was a personal issue for me, because it growing up it was something I really needed, something I really cared about, like having my dad there. A couple of my friends, we had like sporting events and stuff like that. Their dad would be there, and like it would make me feel a little jealous or upset knowing that's the same type of love I wish I can get, but I never got it. But I appreciate it, man, because I'm humble, and I know that once I had kids, man, that's something I would not regret, and something I would not be ashamed to step in to do, because I just want to show love, because you know, I didn't have much of it growing up. As soon as I was born, yeah, there's four little sisters that came right after me, so you know, I didn't get the appropriate love I wish I could have got. But I'm humble for it. If there's any advice I would have to give to anyone that have experienced what I went through, I would have to say, stay strong, find yourself, and find a happy place. I don't see anything wrong with those three. But just find yourself, stay strong, and find a happy place. It worked out for me, and I wish you could take that, and it works out for you, and I wish you the best. And now I just want to send the credits and shout out to my boy Hakira. He's putting together this great inspiration for a lot of people to really just take in and just find out what's really inside them, and just take it further than what they thought they could. It's a great little journey he got going on. I'm glad to be a part of it, and I'm happy for the other people that he had a part of this too. And I hope all is well with them as also. And so this is another I Am, You Are, We Are success story. And I hope you all able to take a lot of positives out of this, and I wish you the best. Thank you.